Hey, do you care whether you live or die?
Lord, knowledge. Bubba on us, look.
Don't step one foot up in the ride, unless you wanna send a vibe that somebody about the motherfucker die from a side where the colors collide. They gotta look up in their eye like a thirst for another homicide. To the side, never get you for the drive, and the way that you would hide is easy for the bullet to come and find. Never mind what it means to define, what did you really define? But they said you be confessing with a lie, nigga. Try to be the one without a substance abusing and live by the rim with a regular influence. The problem is I left it so motherfucker confused in the path that he walks. Nobody would ever choose it, diffusing the situation. But the manifest too evasive, a scar for the heart, but it's hard to erase it. The pain that remains and a drug to replace with the same sad look up on his face. Nigga woke up in the morning with a different type of goals, on cold from the fact that his father was never around, picking up a semi. All about a little victim down, blood drips from the body to the cracks of the ground, and they mash on the gas when they pass 5-0 in the cup. Red lights, everybody like fuck, just lush. Three niggas, two guns, one blunt. Put that motherfucker pistol up under the damn seat. Don't move in the cap, but approach with a boisterous bow. So I got you 250 when the limit 35 B's. Turn the engine off and everybody got a rise. So we sit them on the curb outside. What they found was a stereotype. It wasn't even surprising that he got enough evidence to put him up in a cell. Another young black man with some difficult problems, but the penitentiary will help solve him. Lord,
somebody told me that his life is but a dream. I reside in agony where happiness is never seen. Ask me why I'm so depressed. And I confess my future's bleak with all these voices in my head, and I ain't motherfucking think
that you want, that you want, that you want.
Meanwhile, there's a child like a dad from a gash that was riddled with bullets and tore his body up in half. Through the math, he was on the like 6, caught 5 from a clip. That's a Mac 11, I don't tip straight to the hip. When it ripped through the flesh and the puncture the spine, but it left through the chest and the barrel was suppressed. Now the concrete's a motherfucking mess. But a nigga standing next to the body is feeling blessed. Man, that bullet wasn't meant for an innocent bystander. The losing the grudge and the thing that the violence has a name, but it does. It's the ones that it claimed from the boy that was slain to the young man sitting in the cell. But a nigga that was running away from the bullets and covering hide hops up and finally realized, witnessing the death of his one child through the midst of the madness. The man sits down to reflect on the sight. He was tired of living tripe to this single second and trying to get his mind right. But the triple the force of the moment changed his whole life, and he knows that I'll never be the same. It's bound to drive him insane. He was thinking about the pain that it caused, the emotional loss. But in all actuality, it probably was the cause of the cost. He was playing with a seed. I'm praying that everybody takes heed. Based this off an article I found hidden in a publication. It's not a fabricated allegation, a gory allegory in the moral of the motherfucker story. It's trying to be positive, not deceitful, but a lie. You can never pick the day when you die. Try, be a better person while you're still alive, and search for the divine that you never seen to find. Understand that happiness is the best state of mind. God damn!
I've been terrified of the way I'm living. Cut my wrist, I watch it drip. Oh, I'm forgiven for my sinning. And I'm only 23, but I feel like my life is ending. I've been speaking with Jehovah, and he told me that it's hopeless.
Done!
Yeah, I do. Now it's too late.